Hello everyone! So excited to take you all along on my day. I have so many fun things planned for us to do. My name is Alice. For those of you who don't know me, I am a third year at Davidson College. I went to this really fun gala last night and it's gonna be on my YouTube channel, so click here to see more. And then went to bed kind of late for me, around 11 p.m. I know that's really early probably for all other college students, but I go to bed at 8:30 usually, or 9. I woke up at 6, went to the gym, did a really good workout, moved my body in an intentional way, had some good toast, and now drinking my little latte that I made for myself and listening to my number one house music. I'll put the channel up here as well. They're literally my favorite people ever. Like, literally the only reason why I've gotten through finals like is because of their hype music. So I have so much planned today. As I keep saying, I am going to the community garden. I'm seeing my friend who I met in Argentina. I also am going to go get boba. I'm going to go ride the bus, public transport. I'm going to do some work and then I'm going to go to my friend's concert. And then after that, I'm also going to be going to this special DASAPIAN dinner, which is this alumni group for Pan-Asian identifying students. We are having a DASAPIAN weekend, so I'm really excited. I get to meet some of the alums. And then after that, I'm going to another formal. I'm going to SASA, the South Asian Student Association formal. And so I'm really excited for that as well. So as you can see, so many fun things to do today. And tomorrow there's more things, a brunch, I will interview somebody, and then gonna grind it out because I'm leaving in 4 days, which is insane. Oh my gosh, I have so much to do before then. I'm going back to Vermont and then I'm going back to SF. So I'm so excited. I am going to take you all to my next event after I drink some coffee, relax, do some journaling, and then I'm going to be on my way to the community garden. So I will see you all there. Bye! Okay, I'm here with Paola. Everyone go listen to her new song. It will be released by now. Go watch Paola's single, Taxi Cab. I'll put the link in the bio. Yes! Unreleased content. Hello everyone. I met with my friend Paola and it was so fun. Paola and I met in Argentina. See the vlog here, but oh my god. It is literally fate that I knew Davidson and that she's in Charlotte. So blessed to have her in my life. Feeling very lucky to be just existing here on this earth and being able to get brunch and spend time with those that I love. Feeling just very grateful. I will check in with you all after boba and after
right. It's really awkward, like, yeah,
it's okay.
Awkward.
You don't have to be in it if you don't want to.
Yeah, I feel like I'm gonna.
So the update is we missed the bus. This reminds me of my Argentina times when I would be literally sprinting down the street to get to a bus. And then they just wouldn't come, it wouldn't wait for me. I don't even know. But anyways, that happened again. So classic. Every time the 99's gonna come, I'm gonna be like, that's the time when you didn't stop for me. I'm gonna try to do some work. I am walking back to my dorm. I'm enjoying the beautiful day outside though. It is so nice outside. I feel like it's so important to cherish these kinds of days, celebrate the life that we're able to live. So that's my mantra of gratefulness. So I will see you all later.
Straight out the fucking dungeons at Davidson College.
Just really quickly quickly got ready for SASA formal and also the DASAPIAN dinner. This is my dress. This is what we're working with. Thrifted for $10. I'm running late as usual, so I gotta go, but I'll see you all later. Bye. Oh my God. And it's literally only 9:15, but normalize going to bed early on Saturdays or whenever you want. I need to listen to my body. I'm probably just gonna listen to my favorite YouTubers who just released a video. Maybe do some more of my art project. Not really sure about that, but I have a really busy day tomorrow. But I'm really, really so grateful for everything and everyone in my life. I will see you all tomorrow. Bye. I'm not feeling like 100% sick, but I feel like I'm very in touch with my body and I can sometimes feel when a sickness is coming on. I just want to take time to rest. I'm drinking tea, not coffee, so you know it's real. In these times, I need to give myself grace. I feel like I pushed myself a lot this past week just to get everything done and to grind and to be where I am today. But it's really important to take time to rest. And so I was having all of these feelings of guilt or shame for not going to the gym today. As someone who loves to work out and I don't like to take rest days, sometimes it's really important to take rest days because then you get sick if you don't, or you don't progress as much as you would want to because you're just going too hard. And it's just really important to take those days off. And so even though I plan to hit pull today, I just don't think I'm going to because I don't want to get myself sick in the last 48 hours of being here at Davidson, or more sick than I already am. I think I just need to take time to rest. I went out two nights in a row, which to me is a lot because I don't usually go out, and I just need to take some time for myself. I definitely am gonna journal and I'm gonna watch my favorite YouTuber. Her name is Hitomi. She's literally my savior. I'll see you all later. I'm checking back in. I just finished Hitomi's video. I feel so deeply about the kind of life I want to live and the kind of doorways I want to open and the kind of lives I want to inspire and the kind of being I want to drop into, the kind of heart that I want to have and have open. Just really be so ready for anything in this now. And so this is my manifestation journal, and I just feel so inspired by her and her practice. And just I feel like being here at Davidson sometimes can be toxic in terms of really just, I think higher ed in general can be toxic, and just the kind of narratives it pushes and the kind of environment colleges breed no matter where you are. And so really trying to be able to separate myself from that and really, really meditate on my higher truth is something that I've really tried to work on and something that I'm still working on. So I wrote out some of my goals in my journal. I feel like for me, journaling is such a powerful outlet for cultivating gratitude, and I talked a little bit about this with one of my spirit guides. I really feel like having this routine and having this really calm, peaceful morning every single day is so pivotal in my ways in which I show up in this world and the ways in which I cultivate gratitude for myself and others and grace and show up and love this world with open arms. And so I think that being able to drop in and journal and just like feel so held by the world and cultivating this space within myself where I can feel truly seen is so empowering. And so I really do feel like I've manifested so many things in my life. I would say I definitely manifested within each season the energy I want to bring in and the energy I want to move forward and the energy I want to leave behind, in terms of like, with what intention do I want to move forward into this next chapter? What energy do I feel like needs to be cleansed, and what energy do I feel like I need to bring in more? And so I think through this journaling practice, I've been able to really feel a deeper element of myself and really be able to be in a deeper energetic pathway with my spirit guides and my ancestors, and just showing up every day grateful for the life that I'm able to live. And with that, I feel like if you give gratitude out to the world, you will receive that back, if that makes sense. Like, you will be able to really just feel the love radiate back if you radiate love and gratitude and eternal thankfulness out into this world. That is all. I feel very grateful, and I always feel so much more grounded when I watch Hitomi's videos. So again, check her out. She's one of my favorite people in this entire world, and I feel like she's an older sister, someone that I never had in my life when I was little. So I highly recommend you go watch her videos. Just spent like 3 hours on this art project, maybe up to 5, not sure. But get ready, drum roll. This is my final project. I am so excited about it. So this is for my Africana class, Africana 308, Tony K. Bambara, one of the best classes I've taken at Davidson, and has completely changed the way that I think about Africana studies. Or as my teacher said, June Jordan once said, Africana studies should be called life studies, understanding the ways in which Africana grounds the thinking to be a better person, to take on this world in a anti-capitalist, anti-racist, and anti-sexist way. Here is my final project, and I'm so excited about it. Really excited about creating art as the medium for my final project. I'm gonna write a small write-up on it, but overall, I'm really stoked on how it turned out. I am now gonna go to a DASAPIAN brunch. The DASAPIAN network, the event that I went to yesterday, is for the Asian alumni on campus. So if you are Asian or if you are Pan-Asian identifying, please join the alumni network, because it creates such an amazing community that you can join, as well as amazing opportunities. So definitely join. It's the DASAPIAN weekend. It's the first ever weekend that we are gathering all together in person. So it's been so powerful to meet other alumni, etc. I will talk to you all later. Bye. Just got back to my dorm. I am joining a Zoom meeting for final DASAPIAN Zoom. We had a mentorship program, so I'm joining that right now. And then I have dinner at 6. I'll be eating my meal prep, and then I might be doing a little bit more work, and then I'm done. I literally am so tired. I'm almost there. I'm almost there. I did work at Summit, and I had such a meaningful conversation with one of the alumni. I love them so much, and just having guidance in my life from like an older, more experienced person who's been through Davidson, who like knows just like what life is like outside of Davidson, is so helpful. And so I feel so grateful for, as I was saying to her, as I was saying to this person, this alumni member, I was saying, every single person I encounter is one of my mentors, is one of my spirit guides. Like, all of you who are watching, everyone who I intersect with and interact with in real life, like, they are my guides. Every interaction, every moment is a learning experience and a growing moment, and a moment where we can open up to love. So I feel so grateful. I'll talk to you all later. Bye. Oh my gosh, it's such a beautiful day outside, but of course I was inside doing work. But now I am going to have dinner with my friend Rachel, and I'm very excited about that. I'm going to be eating my meal prep. I meal prep every week. I've meal prepped, I think, like 10 out of the 13 or 14 weeks. I'm really proud of it. I put together some grain bowls, and I just try to get as much free food as possible as well on campus. So I will see you all later. Okay, y'all, I finished my work. Oh my god, I am very dead. I'm very tired, but I finished my essay for this book, and oh my god, my head. But it's okay, we got this. Very, very delirious. It's been such a fun weekend, but honestly so tiring. So I am gonna sign off here now. I hope you all have a great rest of your evening or morning, or wherever this video finds you. I am going to get ready for bed now. I'm so tired. I know it's only 9:30, but like literally I'm so drained. Writing just takes it out of me, but I'm so close. Like literally T minus like 48 hours. I'm so close. I'm counting down the hours until summer. I hope you all found this video helpful. Spending a weekend in my life with me. Thank you so much for showing up just as you are. And that is all from me. I can't wait to see you all in the next video. If anybody has any questions, please do not hesitate to reach out. Here's my email, and I will talk to you all in the next one. Sending peace and love. Bye.